Are you looking for a fast hosting provider with great customer support? Well, in this Siteground review, I'm going to show you everything that you need to know about Siteground so you can make a better informed decision on whether this hosting provider is right for you. I'm not going to waste your time with fluff content here. Instead, I'm going to provide you value by showing you results from my live test, like the page load speed, uptime, and customer support quality. I also provide you with a live demo, so you essentially get to test out Siteground without having to actually purchase it for yourself. And lastly, I will provide you with my honest recommendations on if or who should buy Siteground. I will have a special bonus offer for you if you decide to pick up Siteground through my special discounted link in the description below. I also have a free checklist on starting a successful blog for everyone, so make sure to stick with me to the end and I'll show you how to get access to this bonus. Now let's get straight into this review. After purchase setup and ease of use. Last year, Siteground did a complete overhaul of their systems and moved away from cPanel to their own custom solution, which I really love. It is so intuitive and easy to navigate, so I will now show you by doing a quick install of my WordPress website. So you can see how easy and quick this actually is, right? Now let me show you how easy it is to install your SSL certificate and Cloudflare compared to your typical way of doing it on cPanel. So you just go to security, click on SSL manager, select your SSL and click get. It's literally a one click install. It's that easy. Literally I've only clicked one or two buttons and it's done. And now once your SSL certificate has been installed, then you just go to actions and enforce HTTPS, click on that button. And we're done. And you can easily check this by navigating to WordPress, install and manage, scroll to the bottom, click on this login to admin panel. And now we can see that our website has a lock on it and the certificate is valid. So hopefully this shows you how easy it is to navigate through Siteground's dashboard. And I'll also show you how easy Cloudflare is to install over cPanel in the next section. Overall, I would score Siteground a perfect 10 out of 10 for setup and ease of use. I really can't fault them with anything in this section. I think all users, especially beginners, would love how clean their new interface is and just how easy it is to navigate and do things to your website. I'm very impressed. Speed and uptime performance tests. After I've installed the basic WordPress site, I went ahead and tested out the speed of the bare bones website using GT metrics. The result is 1.1 seconds. This is super fast and is showing great promise considering I've not optimized the website at all yet. So now I will take it a step further and add some design elements to it to increase the page size and the speed will be a bit slower. But don't worry, if you're overwhelmed looking at this, my course that I will provide you for supporting the channel will guide you through this step by step. I'm also going to configure optimum settings for their SG Optimizer plugin by turning on static, dynamic, and memcache. I will also install Cloudflare and the free short pixel image optimizer plugin. This will make it more comparable to what you would normally do in real life. The speed is now 1.9 seconds, as it's way under Google's recommendation of 3 seconds. And is close to being the fastest out of all shared hosting platforms that I've tested. So their SG Optimizer plugin seems to be living up to the expectations so far. Lastly, I wanted to test out their Grow Big and Go Geek plans and see how fast their premium plan really is, and if it's faster than just installing a free speed optimizer plugin. So now I'm going to deactivate SG Optimizer and replace it with the free plugin called WP Fastest Cache. Now let's see what the load speed will be. The new speed is now 2.7 seconds, which is 0.8 seconds slower. So I would say there is enough of a difference here for their Grow Big and Go Geek plans to be worth that extra money. But only when you have enough traffic coming in, of course. At the beginning, I wouldn't worry about it and I'd just stick to their startup plan. Now moving on to uptime. I have been monitoring the stability and performance of Siteground with Uptime Robot and can report that their uptime for the last 30 days is 100%. That's right, their downtime was 0 minutes. In fact, the last time my site was down with Siteground was around 90 days ago, which was amazing. You really can't beat that. Overall, I would rate Siteground's speed and performance a 9 out of 10, as you can't really fault them here on anything, and their speed is lightning fast and is one of the best I have tested for shared hosting. Here's a quick question for you. Do you think Siteground's page load speed of 1.9 seconds is faster or slower than what you expected? Let me know in the comments section below. Support. Siteground has a few different options for you to contact them by. Whether you want to call, email, or live chat them, they are available 24/7 to help you out. Their customer service team is regarded by many people as the best in the industry, so I will test them out by asking them these three different questions on live chat. First, I will tell them that I have been infected by a virus on my website and ask for their help. Second, I ask them a quick question about their SG Optimizer plugin and which plan I need to purchase to get this. But one trick I have on this question is I choose the wrong question category. And the third question is I ask them if they could do me a favor and install the SSL certificate and Cloudflare for me, as I am a complete newbie and I have no idea how to do it. And here are the results. For question one, they were willing to help straight away and scan the website for me to check for the virus. However, they were not willing to remove the virus for me if any were found. It's not ideal, but at least they were willing to find the virus for me and list them out. And then all I have to do was to go one by one into the files and delete them. For the second question, they were able to resolve my query in about 5 minutes, and that includes the wait time. So that's not bad at all. And for my last question, Siteground did not hesitate to install my SSL certificate and Cloudflare. They immediately did that for me and I didn't have to click a single button on my mouse. I was really impressed by their response for that. With regards to the response time, I contacted them at 3 different times of the day to make sure I get an overall average and not just a biased fast response time during their off-peak hours. So their 3 response times were 30 seconds, 10 seconds, and 3 minutes and 15 seconds. So that averages out to be around 1 minute and 20 seconds of wait time, which is definitely the fastest I've tested out of all companies so far. So overall, I would say their support was great and I would score them a 9 out of 10. Their support team was friendly and willing to help immediately without having to ask twice, and their response time is the best I've ever had from any online service, including those outside of the web hosting world. I just took one mark off because they did not actually help with the removal part of the virus scan, and that was it. Do you like the level of detail I'm providing in my review so far? If yes, make sure to like my video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on more quality content that I'll be releasing every single week. Pricing options. Click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. This will bring you to my personal discount page on Siteground where you will get their current best deal available. I will be comparing their shared hosting plan in this review, as that is what most people are looking for. Although Siteground also offers other higher end hosting solutions, like their managed cloud hosting plans, so you know that they are capable of supporting you when you are ready for an upgrade. There are 3 shared hosting plans that Siteground offers. With the startup tier currently costing $6.99 per month, you are limited to just one website and 10 gigabytes of web space, which seems quite expensive to me, considering it was about half this price early in the year before their new pricing model was released. If you require more than one website, then you need to look at the next 2 tiers, which can provide you with unlimited websites. These are called Grow Big and Grow Geek plans, which will cost you $9.99 and $14.99, which is more reasonable and comparable to other hosting providers. I no longer consider Siteground as a budget hosting provider, however, I do believe they are still one of the very best in terms of performance, and I still have my own personal account with them. I will explain to you who I believe Siteground is suitable for later on in the video, so stick around for that. Apart from the standard increase in web space and website visits, the main difference that sets these 2 plans apart from their startup plan, and honestly, many of the other hosting providers, is their speed optimizer plugin called SG Optimizer. On the startup plan, you only get the first level of caching, which is the static caching, but on their Grow Big and Grow Geek plans, you get all 3 levels, which also includes dynamic and memcache. So I'm gonna go all out and get their Go Geek plan. Now with their domain names, I really don't recommend that you buy your domain name with Siteground or any other hosting provider, as they always charge you $15 to $20 per year for just the domain name, and then they will add on another $10 to $15 for domain privacy. So that means overall, you're gonna have to fork out up to $30 per year for a domain name. Other reviewers don't tell you about this disadvantage because they're afraid they're going to lose the sale. But I just wanted to be upfront and honest with you and provide you with the full knowledge to make an informed decision. Now, what I recommend you do instead is to buy all your domain names from Namecheap.com. I use them myself for all my domain names and they have been great. So the main advantage you can see over here is if you buy your domain name from Namecheap, you will get the Whois Guard, which is the privacy protection, for free. And all that for under $10. I've also got a link and tutorial video for you if you're interested in purchasing your domain name through Namecheap. However, if you don't care about the price and you think you're going to stay with Siteground for the long term, then by all means, pick a domain name from Siteground. Now fill out all your private information and we come down to this section. Now we need to choose a data center location. Siteground has 6 locations for you to choose from. I always recommend you choose the location which is closest to most of your customers. So for example, if you have a local business in Australia or New Zealand, then I would choose Australia as my location. But if your customers are worldwide, then I would definitely want to choose the United States. Siteground also comes with very flexible monthly 12-month, 24-month, and 36-month plans. All their plans used to cost the same on their previous pricing structures, so it didn't matter how long you choose, you would always get the same monthly price. But now, their cheapest plan is the 12-month plan, so they are not incentivizing you to buy 3 years like everyone else does. They want you to buy for only 12 months and then renew at this massive increase of $39.99 per month. I really don't like this new strategy of Siteground, and I just think it's a bad business model. It just doesn't make sense why their 24-month plan and their 36-month plan would cost more per month than their 12-month plan. Anyway, I would just pick their 12-month plan, and for the next part is the SG site scanner. This one, I would definitely recommend you not buying it, as it is not necessary. So if you're happy with everything, just confirm and click pay now. The overall pricing score I would give Siteground is only a 5 out of 10. Siteground used to be slightly more expensive than other hosting providers, but they made up for it with their performance and speed. But now with the new price hike, I really don't think their price is great at all, and I can't give them a better score than this. So if you're someone who only needs one website or is just a beginner starting out, I would 100% not recommend Siteground at this price for you. I have a better recommendation which I will share with you later on in the video. If you're someone with a budget and just want the best of the best, then Siteground may still be the best option for you. This is a quick note regarding my bonus offer to you. If you decide to pick up Siteground through my link, just send me your receipt to bonus@.com/dollar and I'll send you access to my bonus course right away. And if you want my free checklist on starting a successful blog, then just go to this link in the description to get access to that. Recommendation. Overall, I have given Siteground an average score of 8.5 out of 10. They really are one of the best shared web hosting providers I've tested. They have great speeds, the interface is one of the cleanest and easiest to use, and their support is also top notch. You just can't beat that perfect combination. So this is my recommendation for you. Whether you're a beginner or advanced user looking for the best overall shared hosting provider, I believe Siteground is a very worthy option that I think you should really consider. However, if you're on a budget and can't afford the fairly expensive price of Siteground, then I don't think they're the right option for you. Now, I think picking the right hosting provider is such a crucial step for your business, so you must get this right. But if after watching this review, you don't think Siteground is the right hosting provider for you, then I recommend you check out this hosting alternative, which I know will do the job. But if you're happy with Siteground, then go to this next video, and I'll see you over in that tutorial.